Today, we use lovely, colorful glazed pots as vases, teapots, teacups, and money boxes. They are made in different colors like blue, black, etc. We also get beautiful jewelry known as terracotta jewelry from clay. Children, terracotta is a type of fired clay, typically of brownish red color, which are used to make beautiful jewelries and ornaments. I am now going to show you images of a potter's wheel, glazed pots. I'm sure you will recognize this potter's wheel, which is used by a potter or kumhar to make beautiful earthenware of different shapes and sizes. These are some images of earthenware made on potter's wheel. They are also decorated. These are the images of beautiful glazed pots made of various materials like ceramica. They look beautiful as they are painted from the outside in bright and shiny colors. ये दिखने में सुंदर लगते हैं क्योंकि इन्हें बाहर चमकीले रंगों से सजाया गया है. इन्हें हम फूलदान और गुल्लक के रूप में भी इस्तेमाल करते हैं. पहले लोग इनमें अनाज भी रखा करते थे. Decorating the surroundings. Since early times, man has kept his surroundings clean and decorated them in his own way. The early man made paintings on his cave walls. Later, he decorated his walls with pieces of mirrors cut into geometrical shapes and arranged them in patterns outlined with white lines. This art is called lipan. Children, a picture of lipan is also shown in your book. Early man, यानी आदि मानव अपनी गुफाओं के दीवारों को सजाया करते थे. हमें भी अपने घरों को सजाना अच्छा लगता है. आदि मानव अपनी गुफाओं की दीवारों पर सफ़ेद रंग की लकीरें खींचते थे जो कि ज्योमेट्रिकल शेप्स यानी स्क्वायर, रेक्टेंगल, ट्रायंगल शेप्स के होते थे. उन शेप्स के भीतर शीशे के टुकड़े बिठाए जाते थे. इस कला को लीपन कहते हैं. I am now going to show you some images of lipan art. Children, this is an image of a traditional lipan art. As you can see, white lines are made with white threads of various shapes. In between these shapes, small pieces of mirrors are pasted. They look beautiful and are a good way to decorate one's house. We also have colorful lipans, which are made of colorful threads and cloth in between the mirrors. They look very bright and beautiful. Madhubani and Worli arts form have become very famous. We also have Gond art, a tribal art developed by the Gonds of cultural India. Kalamkari art, etc. If you visit any house in southern India, you will find beautiful rangolis made outside their homes. It is both an auspicious and a preliminary necessity in any religious rituals. We also decorate our doors with mango leaves, and this is called a toran. On special occasions, we put torans made of beads, mirrors, colorful cloth, etc. at the entrance of our houses. I am now going to show you images of various tribal art. Children, this is an image of a Worli art which I made during the vacations. This is a very famous art form performed by people of Worli in Maharashtra. They make human figures in small triangular shapes with black and white colors. They usually make these arts on the walls of their houses. Children, this is an image of Gond art These are made of bright colors and they are mostly based on animal images. This is also an image of Gond tribal art. Children, this is a Madhubani painting. Another Madhubani painting. These are made of natural and bright colors and are mostly made of human figures and birds and animals. Madhubani art is practiced in the state of Bihar in the Madhubani region. Students, this is an image of a beautiful toran made out of beads, mirrors and colorful cloth and thread, which is used to decorate our houses and doors on special occasions. We also have torans made of mango leaves. This is a toran made of mango leaves and flower petals, which decorate the entrance of a house. They are considered to be auspicious. Inhe शुभ माना जाता है और किसी भी त्योहार और उत्सव के दिन इनसे घरों को सजाया जाता है. Children, I'm sure you now have understood that our country is rich in various cultural art forms. People are very fond of decorating their houses with these beautiful art forms. Please read the chapter and the keywords. Thank you.